President of Iceland, Speaker of the Parliament, ladies and gentlemen. I will now somewhat try to combine my experience within the industry to summarize what we've been through these last couple of days. And I would especially like to thank the organizers of this event for such a wonderful event and thank all the visitors who come from far away to be with us. We are much appreciative. My title slide mentions challenges and opportunities in the geothermal industry. There are quite some. My focus will be on the main components of developing a geothermal project. And there's not very many of them, if we do it broadly speaking. All the other factors involved can be combined with one of these. First of all, it's a resource. We must have a resource. That is obvious in the geothermal industry. We need knowledge, a lot of knowledge, and the widespread knowledge, actually. We need a market for our product, and we need financing. We need the funds to do it. Now I will focus a little bit on each and every one of these four main pillars of geothermal development. Starting with resource. Obviously a necessity in geothermal development, and there are many different kinds of resources. These can be very complicated, these can be difficult to harness, these can be tricky, these can cost a lot of money without success, and these can be absolutely wonderful, as has turned out in so many cases. The regulatory framework combines into this with all the permitting processes needed and the permits we need to apply for in order to get a project going. We also need to emphasize on the environment, to live in nature and not on it, as my mentor Albert Albertsson states. We need to be in harmony with nature. I was once asked by a North American visitor in the geothermal industry if there are any native people in Iceland. And I said, yes, for sure. And he was surprised. I said, we are all natives. We live with the land, with the fish, with the resources. That's the way to go. We have to be extremely careful. By doing so, and by tackling the hindrances and the risks and the challenges, we turn them to opportunities. Some of you have seen them during these couple of days, like yesterday, visiting Svartsengi, Reykjanes, or Hellisheiði. These were challenges that turned into opportunities. In order to do that, you need technology or knowledge. Knowledge you find with people. So basically, you need people. Hitta just mentioned the wing reception afterwards. I hope you have all learned what the wing is. Women in geothermal. Isn't that great? What do we guys do when women invite us to a party? We go to the party at 7 o'clock. There is even a recently established organization by women in the energy business in Iceland. I love that. Have you noticed that all the session chairs at this conference are women? I would say beautiful young ladies. That's a privilege to have so many young people and women working within the industry. I'm old enough to have quite some experience, over 20 years in this industry. I'm at the age of 54. When I was starting in this business, it was considered quite an old tech lame business to be in. I'm trained as an engineer. Most of my friends went to the IT industry around the year 2000 and before 2000. Then they all went to the banks. And I was always doing the same old lame stuff. But now this is on the high wave. Everybody wants to join the clean tech industry. Let's make use of that wave to bring it forward into the future. That is an opportunity, that is not a challenge. Technology also has to do with machinery. The photograph shows us our art museum. What is this but art? There's a lot of interdisciplinary work with different disciplines, people with different education from different countries and different continents. What is shown here is a collaboration between Iceland and Japan primarily, with extremely great results. We have to work with the universities, even colleges or schools below that in the ladder. We have to be active, bring people in, introducing what we are doing. They will carry us forward when we get old. We have to be sure that they will take over, they will have the proper training, be able to do even better than we are doing today. That is an opportunity. We need a market. If we look a little bit back on the resource where I started, the resource is very localized. It is somewhere. And that's what you're dealing with, at a location. The knowledge you can transport, you can move around from where it is to be found to the place where you are working. When the geothermal industry in Iceland was starting up a few decades ago, knowledge had to be brought in from abroad to some extent. Now, bringing knowledge out of Iceland is an export business of Iceland. We have the engineering companies, ESOR and many others, working all around the world in geothermal industry. So that's a kind of a side effect of the geothermal industry in Iceland, bringing export revenue through knowledge of people working all around the world. That was also another opportunity that is being realized. We need a market. The market is also somewhat localized in a way. It has to be somewhere close or at least not too far away from your resource. We can move electricity, serious distances, at a cost, of course. But especially the direct use applications have to be very close to your source. So the market has to be somewhere neighboring your resource. Then there is a fourth pillar, which is financing. That is obviously mobile, movable. For some developers, financing is maybe the most difficult task to deal with. This is very heavy investment related. High upfront costs, very long payback time, usually. So you have to tackle all the risks and make sure that you have a decent project. And the main obstacle in many cases is to fund the exploratory drilling, which is a full risk project. We announced 2 days ago with HS Orka and Statoil that we are going to do a deep drilling project at Reykjanes, the IDDP well number 2. That is maybe the highest ever risk that we have taken. We know what we are aiming for. We don't know, of course, today if we will get it. But we are willing to take the risk. And the risk is shared with many parties. Combining all of these factors, you may have a geothermal project materialized, or even a resource park, as many of you visited yesterday. Please keep in mind, when you go back home, our foreign friends visiting us here, the great fact that our company, HS Orka, employs 60 people, and the resource park employs 600 people. I think that's an important thing to remember. There is so much more to geothermal than power. And we have only just started. We just announced recently that we are going to produce CO2 and which will be sold into the market. We're also going to produce granular silica to be sold into the market. We've been told also about the study of Arna from MIT about lithium extraction from all fluids at Reykjanes. And we don't know what will come after that. Maybe it's going to be gold or silver. These are endless opportunities. You may hear that I focus more on opportunities than challenges. It's more interesting to speak about opportunities. But the fact of the matter is that you have to work through the risks and the challenges to turn them into opportunities, as I have given you a few examples on. And please remember that the resource park is so much more than electricity. Now I want to show you a little bit of our operations in Svartsengi and Reykjanes in a video. Thank you very much for joining.